Hey, good morning. Day 24. Weighed in at 235.1. For breakfast, I had 100 grams of oats, 71.8 grams of peanut butter, a scoop of whey isolate, and then I had a banana. The macros came in. It was like 48 grams of fat. It was like 118 grams of carbs and 53 grams of protein. Anyway, see you in the gym. Good morning, day 24. Good and warmed up. So we're gonna start. We're gonna do the 5x8. You know, we've been hard stuck at 7. This will be the third week now. So I'm definitely gonna shoot for 8, but we're gonna do 5 sets. Just hopefully get 8. If not, we'll do as many as we can. But yeah, show the luscious locks off. And then after this, we're gonna do some chest hypertrophy. I think we're gonna start with the incline, and then we're gonna do some pec deck, then some dips, then some flies, and finish off with some flat dumbbell press. Let's get it. I'm going a lot wider today on my grip. Hold on, Cody. My music will play. Yeah. All right, I got it. Going wider is harder for sure. Dang. But the reason I want to go wider too is because I noticed last week I was stopping at my chin right here. I want to go a little bit wider to get more of a stretch, and you know what I mean? Dang it. Let me drop the weight down a little bit. I'll drop the weight down because I want to do 8. All right. Well, kind of bummed. Because I have been getting a 7, but I did change my formats. So before I was kind of narrow. I did start right here with narrow, but I did some research. Well, research, watch some YouTube. I think it was Ryan Humiston. I don't know how to pronounce his last name, but he was doing the electrodes and kind of showing where to put your hand placement. And he's talking about going wider. And I'm like, man, I really want to like grow my side delts. So I fully expected the weight to go down. That's okay. And I am changing things up a lot. We're gonna keep it the same width and just try to progress from here. It felt good, it was just a lot harder. A lot more difficult, but anyway. Do 4 more sets today. I dropped it down to 115. Do 115 for 8, hopefully. If I didn't just power myself too bad right then.
I'm gonna take my hat off.
All right, yeah. I definitely feel it in my side though. Let's put 2.5 on. That felt pretty good. I could have got 2 more of those. I'm gonna put a 2.5 on. So we'll be doing 120. I'm gonna write this down too. All right, 3 more sets. That felt really good. That felt really good. If you guys haven't noticed by now, I'm really big into form. I know you guys think I have a large ego, but I get enough feed from the deadlift. That really feeds my ego. But like a lot of my weaker lifts, I want to focus on my form now and correct any like bad habits I have. So, and I know you're going to get a lot of front delt doing overhead press or any kind of pressing. It is what it is, but I really want to focus more on my side delts. So I am going wider. That time I didn't go as wide and I felt a lot stronger. So there's like this little like smooth section of the grip. I don't know. It's about 8 inches from like the middle of the bar, whatever. You know what I'm saying? My pinky's riding on that, and that felt a lot stronger, but I'm gonna keep the same weight and same reps. No, actually I went up 2.5 pounds. I went up 5 pounds, so 120. I'm gonna keep it at this, stick with 8, and then we'll start focusing on progression next week and stuff with the same form. You know what I'm saying? All right, go. That was perfect. Yeah, that's perfect. 120 for 8. Let's do 2 more sets. All right, 2 more sets. See where my hand is? I wanted to show you guys where my hand is. This little thing right here. Knurling, whatever. This is what this grip's up. So pinky's right here. One, two, three. I like the stretch going wider too. One more same way. Long enough. I don't think I waited long enough that last set. That's okay. I logged it. Definitely feel it way more in my side delts than I normally do. So if you guys haven't, maybe try going a little bit wider. And you notice my range of motion is way better versus right here. It was really hard for me to go below my chin and really get that stretch. But now since I'm out here, I'm able to really come down and almost touch my chest and push up. So. Yeah, man, that's, you know, I preach this all the time. Don't be afraid to try new things or, you know, perfect your craft. And trust me, it's hard to let the ego go, I know, but I'm not a power lifter. I wanna get, you know, fucking ripped. All right, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, see, I knew I didn't wait long enough last time. Just make sure on your compounds, you're waiting like 3 to 5 minutes. I kind of rushed that last one. And you guys see, I rested. Gotta eat like I wanted, so. All right, we'll see you guys at some incline bench press. Oh, the wide grip, the wider grip on the overhead press is money. My delts are, they're not cooked, but they feel really good. Really, really good, they're pumped for sure. So, I know I said we was gonna do an incline barbell. But I kind of want to rest my front delts up a little bit, so I'm gonna do some high to low cable flies, just 2 sets. Just get really good and warmed up on the chest, and then we'll go do some incline barbell. So just remember, you start like a push, and then make sure to squeeze at the bottom. But yeah, do a couple sets of these, like 15 reps or whatever. Definitely going to failure. But I like to get more than 10 on these flies. Help me get really good warmed up, but yeah. My music will play. But yeah, see, start like a push. Squeeze at the bottom. I think it was 16. Perfect. The high to low, man. That's what's up. That's what's up. Let's do one more set. All right. I was just complaining about how much oatmeal I had. So there's a guy in here, bodybuilder. He's like, I eat 150 grams of oats. I'm like, well, I'm going to try 100, you know, or whatever. And it was tough to get through that. I actually mixed peanut butter in it. And if you guys haven't tried that, I need to get some of that PB2 powder instead. It's a lot lower in fat, you know? But it was good. It was just a lot. It was a lot to eat, but I kind of wish we'd have started with flies earlier to start the workout, because that first set felt awesome. Felt awesome. Let's do one more. My music will freaking play. Let's see if these AirPods. Some days they work great, other days they don't. Alright. Yeah, starting with the flies is money. We're doing this from now on, 100%. Squeeze your chest. Okay, perfect. Oh my God, they're on fire. That's it, let's go do some incline. All right, we're gonna keep 135 on. Just in control. I'm gonna shoot for 12 right here, and if 12 feels pretty easy, I'll put 5 pounds on each side. And do some progressions from last week, yeah? Or progress from last week.
You want lift off?
No, I'm okay. Perfect.
Hello?
Yeah, let's put some more weight on it. Go for the 8 rep range. That felt pretty good. All right, put 5s on each side. Gonna go for 8. Perfect. do two more of those. All right, one more. One thing I didn't mention was, I know it's physically impossible with this bar. When you come down, try to pretend that you're trying to squeeze your hands together as hard as you can. And that'll really put an emphasis on your pec. So come up, and even though I can't, I'm trying to squeeze with my chest. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you do that. Well, do what you want. But I like doing that. It really helps with that mind-muscle connection, you know? All right, two more of these. Cody had to leave us, so let's hope I don't fail too hard on this. Dude, this music is killing me, brother. whatever. Perfect. I kept hitting my mic. I gotta move this down. Whoops. I was so paranoid I was gonna crush it. No, let's do one more. Last one. After this, we're gonna do some more fly action. We're gonna do some pec deck, and then we'll do some dips, and then end it on the flat dumbbell press. And then, yeah, today, I get to take my shirt off. Today's one of those days. But don't fast forward, watch me work out. Oh, my butt came way up. I was scared to fail. Oh, it's perfect. Oh, sick, dude. Starting with the flies, that's what's up, man. That's a game changer. All right. See you at the pec deck. Pec deck. And again, just make sure you're not perfect 90 degrees from your rib cage. Make sure you're like not quite a 45, maybe like a 30 degree angle. Chest proud. I like to stick my butt towards the front of the seat cushion and really squeeze. You start like a press and then you squeeze as hard as you can. Yeah, we'll do three sets of these and then do some dips. Chest prop. Two more. All right, two more. The best thing I ever did for chest was lowering the weight and really controlling, you know, feeling the weight on the eccentric, because just the one set of pec deck and the cable flies and the incline, I really am like, I feel pretty good. I think if I quit right now, it'd be enough volume, but I can't do that, right? It's only been five sets of chest. We need a little bit more than that. Let's get closer, you know, between 10 to 14, and then I'm happy. Thank you. Perfect. Let's do one more. All right, last one. I am pumped.
Feeling good.
Not to the point where it's hurting, but they are pumped. Sure.
Push and squeeze.
Let's go do some dips. All right, I don't know if I waited long enough. I pretty much came straight over here. So just make sure to get like a lot of your lower chest. You want to lean over a little bit. This is 230 pounds I'm dipping after doing some exercises. I know I got 4.5 last week. I'm going to hope to get, you know, 5 or maybe 6. But I'll do one body weight just to see where I'm at, and then I'll do some assisted after that. Try to get closer to the 8 to 10 rep range. £235 now. The cut is happening soon. Almost 7. Yeah. Just some assistance. Alright, just some assistance. Do one more set of that. It's 55 pound assistance. I don't know what that means, but that's what it's on. It's one more set. All right, about a minute and a half rest. Hop right into it. Flat dumbbell press, get out of here. All right, 3 sets of this. I dropped the weight down from last week. I did 60s last week. I told you I was keeping track better. Dropped down to 50s and really slow in control on that eccentric and just squeeze at the top. Thinking 2 sets, maybe 3 of this, and then we're done. See you guys at the studio. And yes, the shirt's coming off. I know. So then, just watch me do this though. Don't skip yet. I need you guys checking my form. That's perfect. Oh my God. It's been a great day. All right. I'm thinking two more. Let's see how this feels, though. I don't think I'm resting in between sets long enough, but that's okay. Let's get out of here. Let's do one more. It's about a minute and a half wait. Feel good, man. It's been a great day. I want to work in those iso presses for the squeeze too. So I'm thinking maybe next week we cut this out and do those iso presses instead. I don't know. I love the split so far today. Well, the exercise for today. Stretch and squeeze. Chest is done. See you guys in the studio. I'm fine with the flat dumbbell press, but my upper chest needs more work. And we are hitting bench press on another day. I think I'm gonna take out the, I'm gonna take out the flat dumbbell press and then do the iso one for the more inclined squeeze, you know what I mean? I mean, we hit some incline, the upper part of your pec with the incline barbell. I just feel like it needs a little bit more, you know? I'm happy with the flies a lot to start with and the dips and even the pec deck. But the flat press, not loving it, not especially at the end because I'm so like, I'm not gassed, but I'm definitely taxed a little bit. And, you know, typically I'll push way more than 50 pounds, but 50 pounds is all I can handle at the end. So I'm thinking dropping the weight and really squeezing the upper pec. I don't know. That's what I'm thinking. But I think the chest exercises are pretty perfect. Pretty perfect. I think we'll just swap that out and then ride with that chest day for the next month or two and see how it goes. Yes, I know. The shirt's coming off. And after a month, I'm thinking like day 31, I'll upload a... I keep forgetting my microphone's over here. I think on day 31, I'm going to upload a before and after like every month. Give you guys like a little comparison. So just work through it. Yeah, see, my upper pec needs more work. I don't know how the lighting is here. Let's move it a little bit. Let's go right here. Yeah. I mean, they're filling up for sure, but my upper needs more work. I'll see you guys in the truck. Day 24.
It's done.
It's done. That was a sick chest day. That was a sick pump. The flies, this sounds silly, man, but when you start with the flies, which I know a lot of people do it, it really activates the chest. I've had a pump the whole time, and it really helped me with the mind-muscle connection on the incline.
And we made some progression. What, last week I did an incline for 135 for 8. I mean, the eccentric was slower, but we went up to 145 today for 8. Like, I'll take that. I'll take that. I kept the pec deck weight the same. But that, dude, you stick your chest proud and your butt out a little bit, and you make sure your arms are just like in line with your nipples. Dude, that squeeze is nice. But I know I said it in the pose and earlier. I'm gonna swap out the flat dumbbell bench for that isolated chest, you know, that chest press. You know, the one where the machine where you start out here and then you squeeze at the top. Cause not that I have a big, you know, big chest, but the upper head of my pec is lacking for sure. I need to get some more thickness up there. So I think we're just gonna do the flat press just on the bench press days, which is fine. That's you know, that's 40 reps on that, which is plenty, you know what I mean? But it was a great day. I don't have my freaking microphone plugged in, do I? Ah, you guys can still hear me. I got this turned on, but whatever. Gosh. I don't know if I ever get this stuff lined up. Let me just plug it up. It sounds better, doesn't it? Oops. Let's see. Got a little too close to the car in front of me. Test. Alright. Whoops. It was a great day. I am extremely full right now. To recap, like, the weight this morning, I weighed 235, and I've weighed 235 for 3 days in a row now, and my diet has been pretty consistent. So, I'm thinking the cut is going to happen pretty soon. I'm thinking 1st of February, we just start eating in a deficit. Not much. So right now I'm eating, you know, I'm still eating 3,200 calories, which is a slight surplus. I mean, it's around my maintenance. It's a slight surplus. And, you know, I fluctuate. Let's just say I eat between 3,100 calories or 3,300, right? Because I'm good about weighing my food, but do I weigh everything out exactly? You know, and there's some still left in the bowl or whatever when I'm eating? Sure. So let's just say between 3,100 and 3,300. So I'm going to start the deficit at 2,800. Lower my carbs down a little bit. I have to do the math. I'm not gonna try to do it while I'm driving. but something like, I don't know, 240 grams of carbs. See, so 250, that'd be 1,000. So it's around 240, something like that. But I mean, you guys know I have a lot of fat. So I'm gonna get some glycogen from burning, you know, from the fat tissue in my body too. So I can go without, you know, loading up on carbs like I have been. But dude, all those oats I ate this morning, I felt sick, dude. And I think that really helped with my pump and my endurance, because I felt good. I could still be lifting right now, but my chest is, I mean, I did 14-ish sets, something like that. That's quite a bit of work. And they were to failure every time. So that was enough, but I could have kept going. The oats is my, I mean, I still like my cereal, my Raisin Bran, but I think loading up on oats like that in the morning before I come work out, I'm gonna start doing that, especially during the cut, right? A little bit better for you than all that sugary cereal. But it was a good day. The incline, we made some progressions there. The shoulder overhead press, I was a little bummed I didn't get 7, but I changed my grip up. I got a lot wider, and I took a lot of the weight off my upper chest and my front delts. Really focused on the side delts, getting that wide grip. So I'm fine with that. You know, we did 8 at 120. That's still a lot of weight, dude. That's still a lot. So I'll stick with that again next week. I took notes of all this stuff. I'm trying to count. I'm still not counting the best, especially my hypertrophy work. But it was a good day. I'm thrilled with today. We got better, and I know that we got better. I feel it. I'm gonna go home and eat. Man, I've been, so there's this hashtag ad, there's this food manufacturer, whatever, food company, real good, it's all one word. They make a lot of, like, burrito, a lot of high protein stuff, but they have this light breaded, they make chicken tenders and nuggets or whatever, but it's only 1 gram of fat, 2 grams of carbs, and 23 grams of protein every 4 ounces. And man, I've just been, to be honest, like I'll just throw them in the air fryer. That's why you guys probably see the air fryer all the time when I'm in my kitchen. But I wear those out. So I'm gonna go home and eat some of that. Have my shake, of course, get some creatine. Oh, by the way, that reminded me. This is TMI. I kind of felt like I was getting a little lactose. Something was off because I was going to the bathroom a lot. So I was like, and lactose intolerance runs in my family. It's never bothered me before. You know, I've been drinking a lot of milk. And I know whey isolate, you know, gets a lot of the lactose out, but there's still, in that protein powder, there's still whey concentrate, which isn't lactose-free. So I've been, you know, I would say 100 grams out of the 250 were for milk. So I was like, I'll cut out milk for a little bit. And, you know, yesterday was great. The day before was a little wonky. But I'm like, man, maybe I am lactose. And, that's one reason why I had the oats instead of the Raisin Bran, which I know I could drink almond milk or oat milk or whatever. But man, I know what it is, dude. It's the pre-workout. It's the non-stim pre-workout or the stimulated. Maybe I'm caffeine sensitive. I just didn't realize it because I didn't have like the runs until I took my pre-workout today and I was in the bathroom again. So, you know, I thought it was a fiber issue. I was not getting enough fiber, so I bought some psyllium husk, and I took the milk out. But I think it's the caffeine, man, or the pre-workout. The other pre-workout didn't do that to me. And the caffeine was the similar dosage in each of them. I don't know, man. I don't know if it's because I'm stacking the non-stim with the stim, if it's, like, too much. I mean, I know you'll get, like, pre-workout poops, but this is, like, the runs almost. You know what I'm saying? To the point where it's, like, uncomfortable at times. But I ordered some new pre-workout too, just because I was running low. So I ordered the extreme stimulated. I know I was just talking about caffeine sensitivity. I ordered the extreme stem gorilla mode. And then I ordered the sebum, the raw, the pump, the NO, you know, the glycerin. It's just got glycerin in it. So I was going to use the stem and just dump the glycerin in it and try that for a little bit. Make sure I get a good pump. I don't know. We'll see how my body reacts to that. I'll start with a half a scoop because I'm a pretty wired guy anyway. I'll start with a half a scoop and see how I feel. You know what I mean? I don't know. I'm just trying to figure out which pre-workout I really like. And I don't think it's weird to, like, rotate them out. But, man, I don't know. I was spoiled. You know, when I got into working out, like, 2013, that's when Jack 3D was out. And in the back of my mind, like, nothing will compare to that. And, like, the Crave one, like, there were some crazy pre-workout stimulants on the market back then. But Jack 3D, I know it had the DMA, the, you know, it got took off the market because it had, like, some form of meth in it or something. But, dude, that high you got, there's nothing like it, man. There's nothing like it. So I know you can still probably find it and probably have to pay a lot for it, but DMAA stuff kind of scares me a little bit, so we'll just stick with caffeine and citrulline and, you know, beta-alanine and some mushroom complex, you know, for focus. We'll just stick with the more holistic stuff, you know, for now. I love the glycerin and the citrulline for the pump because, and I say this every, I feel like I say this every workout video, you know, pump is not an indication of growth, but when you make that, it helps you make that mind-muscle connection. If your muscles that you're trying to activate are getting pumped, and it just feels good. You feel full, man, you know. Not that I'm a club person anymore, but, you know, if I was going to the clubs, I'd be going to the gym getting a pump and then going out, you know what I'm saying? Or if I lived on the beach, like, get those muscles inflated a little bit. But it was a good day, man. It was good. I'm really liking the split. I'm recovering well. My deadlift, I'm still a little spicy on the rectors and the in my glutes, but that's okay. That was a lot, man. I actually went back. I didn't give myself enough credit. I did 40 sets, so that last, or 40 reps, that last set I did 7. I thought I did 6, and then the other set I did 9 instead of 8. It's just really hard for me to, like, count and be intense. Does that make sense? But after I was watching the footage, I was like, oh snap, I did 4. So we did 40 reps at 320 pounds. That's nuts. You're gonna be cooked for a while, but I'm excited, man. I'm going to bump it up. I think I'm recovering. I'm getting strong enough to bump it up by 5 pounds next week. So do like 325. According to the one rep max calculator, it said my one rep PR was 414 or 415. But, man, I don't know. I don't know. I'm not, by no means am I going to try to do that. I think I can get 365 if I was fresh for sure. I might be able to get 405 if I was really fresh and warmed up. But we're going to, like I said, we're going to plan for those. I'm really trying to let my ego go, you know, because I'm doing this to bodybuild, not powerlift. So we're going to, I know you have to plan for your powerlift, you know, PR days too. So we're going to plan those out a little bit better. A little bit better. I don't ever like taking deload weeks. I think your body needs to recover and rest, but I'm not a big fan of deload week. I'm a big fan of listening to your body. And maybe about the PR week, we'll dedicate maybe every 6 weeks, we'll do like a PR / deload week where we're just going there and reassessing our max and then recalculating our progression methods, you know, our lifting methods. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. But yeah, today it warmed up. It's a warm 14 degrees right now. So it has been cold. Give you some personal matters. Yesterday, the reason why I didn't record a video is my rest day, but I had some stuff planned, but everything was breaking on me. So my master bathtub completely clogged up. I had a snake in there. Oh man, I gotta call a plumber or something. I had a snake. So I have two snakes. I have an auger and a snake, but the auger was too big. It's more for like a toilet, and I couldn't get it in the drain. I couldn't get it to fit. And the other little cheap snake I had, I was hitting something solid. I don't know if it was pipe or the sludge clog or what, but I'm gonna give it another go today. And if I can't get it, I gotta call a plumber. And then another thing, my washing machine, I have an error code on it, 4C. So I looked that up and it was a water pressure issue. So I don't know if the pipe is frozen because of the cold weather or if it's a sensor. And it scared me at first because like, oh my goodness, like frozen, like burst the pipe, but I don't hear any water running. So I don't think anything broke, so that's good. But yeah, man, that's the thing. When you get older and you get your own house, it's something's always breaking, it seems like. But yeah, anyway, much love. Make sure you guys turn those notifications on so you guys don't miss anything. Again, like, I'm not going to plug that every day. I figured, like, every other day, because the alerts are set to personalize when you first subscribe. So make sure you click and click all so you guys are getting notified when I upload the shorts. But you guys know I upload every day at 10 a.m. Well, most days. 10 a.m. Pacific time. Yeah, we're 3 away from 200. It's 6. So 800 more subs. I swear to God, I'm getting a better camera. I'm getting a better camera. It's gonna be dope, man. It actually comes with its own microphone, so it's gonna be nice to have a backup with the camera one. You know what I'm saying? So the lighting and stuff, it's got a built-in gimbal. It does active tracking. It's gonna be sick. It's gonna be really sick. Thankfully, I got some friends that do a lot of videography, and they were super helpful. So shout out to you guys. But anyway. Go home, eat some chicken, get some rice. I had 500 grams of rice yesterday. Not in one sitting, but two split up. I love the Uncle Ben's, man. I know you're paying for it, but the Uncle Ben's, it's just so convenient. You throw in the microwave for 90 seconds, and the jasmine rice is so good. I always mess up jasmine rice when I cook it. It's either too crunchy or too soggy, man. I don't know. I grew up in Kentucky. We didn't eat a lot of that fancy rice, you know what I'm saying? I grew up on pot roast and cornbread, you feel me? Soup beans. My diet has changed a lot since I left home. But I love jasmine rice. It's so good. I've been making a lot of like Korean barbecue. Get like the round bottom steak strips. Whew, man, I might have some of that tonight. I've not had a good cheeseburger in a while too. But anyway, we're so close to 300 or 200. We got 3 subs away. I appreciate it so much, man. Thanks for all the love, positivity, feedback, you know, advice, guidance, all that stuff. You guys stay warm, and we'll see you tomorrow for some squats and biceps. Is tomorrow squats and biceps? I gotta look it up. Anyway, we'll see you tomorrow. Peace.